Hey guys, today I'm going to give you a complete guide on how to beat three different types of log bait decks with Lavaloon Classic using the Barbarians. I'm going to be talking about the offensive strategies, the defensive strategies, and just give you some good solid gameplay against log bait. So hopefully you guys can learn from this. And if you do enjoy this video, please consider leaving a like and a comment, as well as subscribing if you're new. So I'm hoping to revive the matchup guide series. And I know lots of you guys like live gameplay, but to be able to make the most effective matchup guides, it's going to be easier for me to evaluate replays. Because if you think about it, it's really hard for me to just like, I don't know, put together matchup guides from live gameplay, because I'm not always playing live. So I just find the games and then I record over them. So as you can see, just like that, we want to get as much damage as we can without overspending, because if you overspend, he's going to counter push you heavily. And in single, you want to make sure you play a ton of defense. Do not try and tower trade versus log bait. It's not going to work out. I don't care what you think. It's not going to work out. Don't take unnecessary damage. Just play the best defense you can. So here, as you can see, he's going to go in with a massive push, which I kind of didn't expect. I probably should have just barbed on top, because I didn't expect the Barbarians to just disapparate there. So that was a little unfortunate. But as you can see, we play decently okay defense, and we're gonna take down to like 2200 damage, but we still dealt a lot of, I guess we didn't deal a lot of damage off that counter push. That's not what I meant. I mean, we only are down 1000 damage at this point, so it's really good for us, because as long as you're not trailing by too much, you'll be just fine. So I went lava instead of going in the princess. I went into this lane because I was thinking the drags can be used as offense and defense, because we want to make sure we're not getting too low on our tower, but we also don't want to over defend, because then we'll have no elixir for offense. Our number one offensive strategy, get the princess out with the fireball, and then you want to try and use lava loons or just lava skeleton dragons as your main offensive push. Now, as you can see, princess is out of cycle, so he's not going to have a good way to wrap up this push right here, so we're going to deal an absolute ton of damage. Don't go lava until you are having a tombstone down, so that you can't get punished that hard. And he went full in opposite lane, but it's not going to be enough to get him into rocket range. So as you can see, he's down a little bit of elixir. The skeleton dragons are going to lock onto this inferno, which is huge. We are going to zap the inferno, fireball the princess, and we're going to get a ton of damage. I think we might seal the game on this push. You just got to be careful. Apply as much pressure as you can without like overspending. See, as you can see, we have enough elixir for the barb, so that play was fine over on the right side. But basically, you're just going to want to make sure you're never overcommitting. Always be patient, and it's pretty simple, honestly. If you get the hang of it, you've just got to go lava skeleton dragons. Make sure his princesses are clear. Don't go lava into princesses. Make sure the princesses are off the board. Yeah, but we're going into this Mighty Miner bait matchup here. And of course, if you guys have any questions, feel free to let me know in the comments or in our Discord server, which is in the description, because I know I can't cover everything in the video. So if you have any questions, just let me know and I'll do my best to clarify them. But yeah, we realized pretty quickly on that with the skeletons, it's going to be either cheap log bait or Mighty Miner bait. So we go drags here, just wrapping up the princess. The drags are also going to force out a response, which is nice. You've got to think about that as well. With bait, any damage you can get early on will be amazing. So if you can get like extra chip damage from going skeleton dragons, then try and do that. With the Mighty Miner bait, the big issue is you have to play extremely defensively in single, in my opinion, because if you can stay alive long enough to get into double with like a tower still up, you're gonna be very nice, because you're not going to have to worry about, you know, overspending on defense. So always make sure that you've got something in hand for his Mighty Miner. Now, I completely waffled there, because I thought he was going to go with the Goblin Barrel with the same lane as the Mighty Miner, but he didn't, and I was kind of delayed there. Like, you know that weird thing where you place a card and it takes like 1 second to place and you're like, oh shit, I shouldn't have placed it there, but I accidentally did anyways. So that's what happened there. It was a little annoying, but we had the zap to wrap up the Goblin Barrel. And so here we're still chilling because we're only down 900 damage. It's not a lot, considering, you know, that he usually, if you play it wrong, you can be down like a tower and a half at this point. So I go lava because I know the princess is the only thing he has for our lava, and his Mighty Miner was out of cycle, so we could go barbarians. And I go barbarians, interesting, over here, because it's gonna wrap up the barrel and most of the Mighty Miner, forces him to switch lanes and gets a rocket out of him, which is amazing. And watch this play here. He wants the cannon pulled to the King Tower, so we zap last second here and make sure that we aren't we aren't going to that King Tower. I've done that play a couple times in my career, and that was a really nice play right there to make sure we won this game, because if you're playing smart, you should always be able to use a tombstone for his Mighty Miner. I'd always try and tombstone pull the Mighty Miner, never like go tombstone behind tower if you can avoid it. And so we just pressure him with the barbs loon in the pocket, and as you can see, the good pressure, the patience, not going down in single, allows us to wrap up this game pretty nicely, because we never gave him like an opportunity to go ahead and pressure us. We always had a response ready for his Mighty Miner, so that was pretty nice there. Lastly, we've got Christian, who's playing Logbait Tornado, which is a little bit better, I'd say, than the Inferno Tower version. Definitely better. However, it's Logbait, and it can still be pretty tricky if you get caught behind, like getting out cycled and going lava early. So once again, do not go lava early. Don't let him pressure you. It's pretty much the same for all Logbait types. Do not let him pressure you early. Stay ahead of him in elixir, in cards. Just make sure you're playing good defense until double elixir. And just simple plays like zapping Goblin Barrel, Goblin Gang. We're having to spend the barbarians here on this princess, but it would work out because he's got to spend a ton of elixir on these barbarians. And so as you can see, he's going to spend 5 elixir on 5 elixir, which is basically 5 elixir on 8 elixir, so we came out of that trade plus 3. So tombstone here, just to place a tombstone down, because if I had any intentions of going lava here, then the tombstone being down would allow me to go lava without being pressured too hard by like a Goblin Gang or a knight or something. We're going lava here because now we have got a Mega Minion on the board, a Tombstone on the board, and his Goblin Barrel is out of cycle. So it's looking nice for us there, and I was prepared to go drags behind my lava. However, I made sure I played some defense, and as you can see, I went with the Barbarians because now he has got to deal with Barbarians. He's got to deal with Barbarians on the left and lava on the right, and the lava is going to chip away at that tower, dealing a ton of damage. And also here, which is a good thing, I can go loon because he has no elixir. I don't think I ended up going loon, but I could have gone loon because he has no elixir. And so as you can see, we're just gonna zap that, and we're gonna get a ton of damage and force out a knight. So it's looking very good for us here, because as if we're forcing out knights on defense to tank for the pups, he's not going in on offense, which is beautiful. So we go with the tombstone behind there, the drags as well, just to make sure we wrap up that barrel and also take out the princess. So I decide to go fireball, I believe, because it's a really nice fireball value, man. I took out Goblin Gang, princess, and ice spirit, so that was very nice. And we go lava over here. We're just chilling. We want to make sure that we're not giving up any extra damage. The barbarians are coming in. We are using the Mega Minion to block the princess so that the princess is not splashing onto our tower, because we don't want him to be in rocket range. Now the drags come down. We are going to fireball this barrel just to make sure it's not getting a bunch of damage. As you can see, the Skelly Drags chipping away. Out comes the NATO. The drag's dealing a ton of damage, and now we've got a loon coming in here because he is so low on elixir, he's not going to have enough to rocket it. And ladies and gentlemen, we're going to win that game off of a clutch balloon hit. And if we can keep the opponent from rocketing our tower in situations like that by going with a balloon, that's going to be very good. So hope you enjoyed the video, and let me know any comments or clarification that you have.